Welcome back
to another episode of our How Not to Build a Camper Van series. And can we just say,
it's December!
And before we jump into the van stuff, let's get a bit Christmassy.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can't see.
Okay, so now for the van stuff. And this is where I drove Bohemia for the very first time.
It's Sunday morning, and other than a quick stop start, we actually haven't taken Bo for a drive, and Steph has never driven her properly. So now's the time to find out if we're actually going to keep her. In this episode, we fit the 240 volt hookup, even though it actually hasn't got any electrics yet, and we finished the vapor barrier.
So Els is basically preparing for us to fit our 240 volt hookup. I'm literally holding my breath right now. It's just so sudden, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Like, it goes through and you're like, what?
I'm not a fan of what's happening right now.
This is why you weren't here when I did the skyline.
This Bo didn't sound like she liked it.
Well, she's not gonna like it, but she's getting a nice new booby hole.
Aren't you doing more holes?
Yeah. What, are you off? You're panicking me a little bit.
I'm not. I haven't said anything.
I want you to video it.
Why? If it goes wrong, it'll be there with you forever.
Forever. Sure,
dear. Staring at it, it's not gonna cut those holes, is it, babe?
Whoa, what happened there?
Where did it go?
It must have gone inside.
Yeah, it's there. Right, should we try that again?
Yes.
That's scary. It's all right.
The wood one.
Yeah. What, is it not doing anything?
Oh. I just don't know how good it's gonna be. Help. Help.
Hello.
And along came help in the shape of Farmer Richard and his angle grinder, because the only jigsaw blade we had left was for wood. Although the angle grinder didn't actually do what I'd hoped. Onwards and upwards, we went to go get some new jigsaw blades and whacked on some Christmas tunes to pick us up.
I feel sorry for Natalie and Charlotte that had to do this with two windows.
I know.
The actual thing that's going in it.
Oh, 2 seconds. That definitely does not fit.
It's alright, it's the first time, it never does.
Come out. More here.
It's easier now that there is a hole.
How's it going, babe?
Take a bit more off, see if it fits. We're nearly there.
Nearly?
Yeah. Literally, by like... Oh, I wish I could just like smudge it in.
It's metal.
I know.
Please go careful. Huh? Please go careful. There was bits like flying off everywhere there. Okay.
Steph painted around the rim and now she's used electrical tape. So we were going to use mastic tape, but I left it at home. I think that it's just going to like stop it from being so abrasive on the actual, no idea what we're talking about.
Well, I'm going to try and talk, yeah. But it's a little bit difficult.
Cause Steph just got back from the dentist.
I've just had two fill-ins. But basically, the idea of using the electrical tape is just to help it go in a bit smoother. Obviously, we have filed down the metal as much as possible, but it still scratches the plastic, and we want to keep everything as smooth and nice as possible. What are you doing now?
Leave them alone. I'm gonna just screw it in now, and then it's done.
Okay. So, are you pre-drilling the holes, or just gonna drill straight into it?
I'm just gonna go straight through. I'm gonna see what happens.
Okay. Fair enough.
I'm going to pre-drill the hole. Let's get some more screws. Bearing in mind, I just did all of that. Crosshead screws with flathead screw bit. Pro. It's done!
Yay! We have the hookup. I mean, it's not hooked up yet, but it's in.
So we fit the 240 volt hookup. There's no electric running through it yet, but stay tuned because in a couple of episodes I'm going to be running all of the wires, including our 240 volt. So if you want to learn or not, come back for that one.
Okay, so I'm at Bo on my own this morning because Elle's is doing some chores with my mum and stepdad. So the first thing I had to do was obviously turn Bo on, get her engine started, just because obviously it's cold and also we're not driving her as much, so her battery's gonna go flat pretty quickly. We've had to recharge her a couple of times. But then the next thing for us is we're finally finishing our vapor barrier and laying our floor. Oh, hi dogs, no, don't pee on, no. That's where I put all of our bits. Hello. Anyway, as I was saying, we're finally getting our floor down and the vapor barrier done. So now I've got to move all of this onto this where the dogs just peed. Okay, I'm just gonna quickly talk you through what I'm doing. So this is where our windows are in here. Obviously we've got the low-E vapor barrier here, and this is some more low-E vapor barrier. So I've stuck it along the bottom, and then what I'm doing is I'm stuffing it with insulation. So technically low-E is insulation, but because it's windows and glass, and that's where the most kind of cold or heat is going to be let in from, I am giving it extra insulation by using this. And this stuff is so damn warm. It's 100% recycled plastic, which is a win-win. And it's not toxic either, because I know that there's some insulation up there, especially like loft insulation, that isn't good to use in your van just because of the toxins that it can give off.
Oh my God. Difficult to do on your own. Okay. Ow. Always hurting myself.
I need Ella. Hurry up and get here, babes. In the meantime.
Show Ella that I can do this on my own without supervision.
Hey baby, I'm back.
God.
Thank God.
Look what you've done so far. I am impressed. You're in your pajamas underneath. Okay, so I'm going to try and explain this as simply as possible and as quickly as possible. So in our insulating the floor episode, this is obviously what we did. Then we whacked ply on the top, and the plan was to then put our flooring on it, which is like a vinyl flooring. What we're going to do instead is run the lowy, or the vapor barrier, from the windows all the way down, and then we're also going across the floor, as you can see what Steph's done there. And then we're going to put the ply on top. So the next day we are back down at the van. We've nearly finished our vapor barrier. Steph's trying to save a fly right now. So obviously in previous episodes we insulated the ceiling, we insulated the floor. Yesterday we lifted up the ply, just the vapor barrier, and now we're just finishing off the vapor barrier around our windows. And these are the windows as well that we're blocking out. If you're here for aesthetics, go away. Yay. I'm not making fun of your corner. Your corner's great.
No, it's not.
That's all for now, folks. Thank you very much for watching.
And if you liked us, or if you're just here for bants, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and a subscribe.
Hey!
Next time on How Not to Build a Camper Van.
Come back next week to see us fit our garage floor and our snazzy new laminate for the rest of our camper van.
So I'd say that our biggest flaw in our How Not to Build a Van series is that we never ever have everything that we need. Ever.
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 Ever ever.
Ever ever.